caused him to remain. For whenever two or more of you are gathered in his name, there is love. There is. It was in the beginning, is now until the end. Woman draws her life from man and gives it back again. There is love. Oh, there's becoming man and wife. Is it love that brings me here?
However, at 59 years old, I think I'm allowed to say what I feel in my heart. This very beautiful evening of Matthew and Jacqueline's wedding day. At the end of the day, it's my heartfelt speech, and I'll begin it now. I would like to start up on behalf of the bride's parents, Mark and Rosie, myself and my wife Beth, the groom's parents, Robert and Debbie, and giving all of you a warm welcome, and to all the relatives and friends from both sides of our families who have joined us to celebrate Matthew and Jacqueline's special day. I know that many of you have traveled long distances to be here, like from the great state of Ohio and New York and possibly other parts across our nation. Thank you all for coming to help celebrate this very special day. As I look around the room, I realize how many friends Matthew and Jacqueline really do have. I hope that all of you have a wonderful afternoon and evening, and today I must admit, I am the proudest dad in all the world to have accompanied Jacqueline and Matthew today. I think all of you will agree that they look fantastic. To say that their parents and I are both very proud of how they look together and how she looks today. And she has grown up, and we are both very delighted that she has found someone she obviously loves and cares so very much for. Matthew, Jacqueline, there are two things that we as parents try to give you, our children. One of them is roots, and the other is wings. Jack, Matthew, I immediately dropped everything I was doing at work, and I thought he was kidding. Are you ready, Matt? I asked him, and without missing a beat, he said, yes, sir, I am. And this weekend, we're coming over to visit Mark and Rosie, and I'm going to propose to Jacqueline and give her the ring specially designed for her. Jacqueline doesn't know yet, and I wanted to ask you first, sir. Well, after catching my breath, I said, Matthew, it would be an absolute honor for me to grant your request and accept you as my son. Matthew has many outstanding qualities, not the least of which is an innate and keen ability to appreciate the finer things in life. Well, after all, he did marry our daughter. Now I'm going to get to the delicate part of my little talk, if I may. I'll just give you two a little bit of advice on the subject of marriage. Many would probably say that I'm not really the best person to provide advice on the subject of marriage for the right reason. And I think you both have done that. Add to that respect, and the rest will fall into place. Easy? No, it's not easy. And it won't be easy. Nothing worth having or good in this life is ever easy. After that, I had better finish. But before, let me close by offering my final thought. May you too be blessed with happiness and joy, a happiness and joy that grows with a love that lasts forever. And yes, until death do you part. I wish you the enjoyment for today and the fulfillment of all your hopes and dreams for tomorrow. And love and happiness always. And now, it is my pleasure to propose a toast, together with my colleague, Bart, to our loving, happy couple. Please join me in proposing a toast, and raise your glasses high. Two cups to the bride. Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Jacqueline Kilburn.